All right, Shalom, Shalom. I want to start off by saying Barakatah Yahawah, Barakatah Yahawashi, Barakatah Yahawah, Barakatah Yahawashi, Barakatah Yahawah, Barakatah Yahawashi. Kol Halalai, Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi. That's Hebrew. Interpret, bless Yahawah, bless Yahawashi. All praises to the Father Yahawah, in the name of the Son, Yahawashi. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect scattered abroad, teaching his word in sincerity and truth. Shalom. All right, this lesson is going to be quick, and I'm going to try to keep it straight to the point. I was in conversation, and this scripture popped up. All right, this scripture popped up in my head, so I want to just do a quick show with it, you know, because the spirit in which we have to be in is being a soldier. You know, not just a soldier, which you might think a soldier in the army, you know, we have to put on the mannerism of a soldier toward Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi for this truth's sake. Alright? And it's a lot of shit you're gonna go through and a lot of shit that, you know, gonna come across your way. But the Lord told us to take it cheerfully, you know? And we always good for going through adversity and going through hell, because this is our sufferings, you know. But there is hope and faith, because the Lord Yahawashi, you know, he gave his body as a living sacrifice, you know, for his sins first, and then also for the Israelites, in particular the elect. All right, and Yahawashi is on his way, you know, straight up. You know, if you can't see the Lord today in this godforsaken wicked place, then you're never going to see the Lord unless, you know, you die on this side, all right, and see him in the spirit room. Because there's so much wickedness going on that, you know, like I said before, you know, it's a lot more easier to see the Lord, you know, because of all this wickedness that's going on, and more evilness, you know, and wickedness is increasing. All right, so anyway, 2nd Ezra chapter 14 and 14, let go from thee mortal thoughts, cast away the burdens of man, put off now the weak nature. You know, now this is the attitude we have to carry in this truth, because if you don't, you know, you're going to be sucked into this world, and you're going to be dragged down by the demons that's plaguing you. You know, Satan is like a roaring lion, okay? He's out here to, you know, to mess you up. You know, he's out here to put, you know, to cast away your faith, take away your faith from Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi. All right? It says, let go from thee mortal thoughts. Now, mortal thoughts is thoughts of the flesh. You know, shit that matters, but really, you know, does it really matter? All right? You know, because we all go through this life, and it's things we need and things we want, things we would rather have, but things we don't have. So does it matters, but really, but the question is, does it really matter? All right? When it comes to salvation toward Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi. So the Lord said, let go from the mortal thoughts. Let the mortal thoughts go. It says, cast away the burdens of man. Now, we have burdens. We're in this rat race. You know, we're in this system pit. You know, this pit Esau created. And in this way of life, we have to live. And we have a lot of burdens pressed against us. All right? But the Lord said, put ye the Lord first, and all these things shall come, roughly paraphrasing, you know. So you have to put your everything into Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi. So the Lord said, cast away the burdens of men, put off now the weak nature. Because it really, you know, if you allowing Satan, well, let me not say that, if you're allowing your flesh to get the best of you, you know, then you're in a weak nature. You know, you got to be strong. It's all about being strong spiritually. You know, that is the greatest fight right now. It's a spiritual war, you know, mentally, you know, being able to say no and sacrifice, you know, and stand for righteousness. So it says, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from these times. Now, you know, like I said before, man, it's a lot of shit that brothers go through, and brothers got burdens on them. But the Lord said, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee. You know, because brothers have heavy thoughts, you know. But them thoughts turn to demons, man. And them demons will, you know, stick on your ass until he break you. Okay? So the Lord is here with these scriptures to strengthen us. So, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from these times. So that's why when you are suffering, man, we're praying to Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi. All right, to haste to flee from these times. May the Lord shorten the days for the elect's sake. Okay? May the Lord crack those clouds and, you know, fulfill prophecy, delivering the elect. You know, may the Lord have these Edomites 2020 start forcing this, or, you know, forcing this RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast. Because once these devils start having great wrath and coming down upon us, we know that it's not long left. All right, there's not long left for his kingdom. All right, because ours is right around the corner. Verse 16, for yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen shall happen shall be done hereafter. All right, for look how much the world shall be weaker through age, so much the more shall evils increase upon them that dwell therein. For the time is fled far away, and the leasing is hard at hand. For now hasteth the vision to come which thou hast seen. And what we see the word. Okay, the Most High has opened our spirits up to see the prophecies being fulfilled. Okay, he told us that these things are going to come to pass. Jacob's trouble, the force of the mark of the beast, all right, World War III, thermonuclear destruction, destroying this land of North America, aka Babylon the Great, all right, deliverance to the Israelites, the elect in particular, all right. So it says, for the time is fled far away, and leasing is hard at hand, for now hasteth the vision to come which thou hast seen. All right. So, you know, because it applies to us as well. He's talking to Edris, but Edris saw the end. Okay, the Most High showed Edris in this day, you know, what it was going to be in the very end before the second coming of our Lord, which is Yahawashi, who the world ignorantly call Jesus Christ. You know, so I hope this lesson was edifying. I want to give all praises to Yahawah BaHaSham Yahawashi, BaHaSham Qadash. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect. Shalom.